The Gulf of Mexico is a bacteriological and bacteriophage, and there's a lot of life there in simple cell structures. Without getting into all the biological names, it is just a living sea, or it was, and all seas are. The most simple life forms are found in a sea at the microcellular structure. So within all those, this hidden electromagnetic structure is in those microbiotic structures within the seas as well. And they say that scientists and such say that the seas are the building block of all life, whether it be, you know, humanity or animals or whatever. So now just remember that. Okay, now let me read a little bit more of what he says in this paragraph. Now, he's writing about the Soviet technologies that were known back in the 80s and were experimenting back in the 70s even, but they started to put it together in the 80s, and he's speaking about their technology right up to when he wrote the book in 1991. He said, the Soviets know that it is this enfolded and hidden electromagnetic structure, what he said was the internalized or covert EM energy, that is deterministically utilized by living biological systems in all their cellular control and regulatory functions. Just about what I said, we have that hidden structure that's electromagnetic, and he explains it's utilized by every living biological system. Then he says, by deliberately manipulating this internalized electromagnetic energy structure, which he explained earlier was within the scalar EM potential, that the Soviet scientists have found it possible to accomplish astounding electromagnetic biological effects, both for healing and for biological warfare, that are entirely undreamed of in the West. Now, again, he wrote this 1991. Things, I'm sure, have changed since then, and the Western world, so to speak, could be very aware of it and has something even way beyond this. We don't know. And then he finishes up to say, the Soviet energetics technology can manipulate, change, control, or destroy literally any of the key biological functions of the living system, including mental and behavioral functions. So are you getting the idea that this electromagnetic manipulation of that hidden plan book, so to speak, for every living thing? Now, he's saying that the Soviet scientists are able to use that not only for healing, but they can change the biological structure through electromagnetic waves so that something that would normally be a certain pattern of electromagnetic pattern of how that certain life form evolves, and it follows that electromagnetic pattern that they, back before 1991, at least those scientists then, were able to alter the biological structure of that plan book, that electromagnetic structure, the hidden one. And they had figured all this out. And in fact, in a couple of his books, he goes in to talk about how he was they were working on this right after World War II. So he is saying that the Soviets were very, very advanced in this, that their scientific teams, this was their number one thing. And if you had listened to a couple other the shows last week, I did mention how he had, you know, said the Cuban Missile Crisis had to do with this. But we're not going to go back into that. I want to get into you in your head that this applies to what's going on in the Gulf of Mexico. Saturday, I had said, it's a dead zone. It's not just dispersant that's being sprayed. Something that's being put in water and sprayed on the water is deliberately destroying all the oxygen. Now, okay, possibly a byproduct of dispersing the oil does that, but the thing is they've been spraying it where there has been no oil. So that's kind of a key to me when I'm reading things from people saying, yeah, they sprayed over my house on the beach on my condo. You know, they're spraying real close offshore, but there wasn't any oil slick out there. So to me, I would say the spraying has another purpose. And the effect of all this spraying is just what it is. You can't take the effect away, and that effect is removing the oxygen out of the seawater. And you'd have to understand, why would they want to basically destroy every living organism, from porpoises to whales to fish to plankton to every bacteriophage, every bacteria that's in the Gulf of Mexico? They're deliberately starving it. And when you remove oxygen, nothing can grow. Nothing can reproduce without oxygen. Nothing can survive without oxygen. So it must be deliberate for that being done. And that also explains why you have military police and you have all sorts of different army troops guarding the containers on land near the airports and the warehouses of what is supposed to be a dispersant and corrects it. Liz, am I getting too far ahead? Is this making sense?
Tell me to back up somewhere. I'm just listening and making sure that I understand what you're talking about. And so far, everything's registered with me. So,
well, good. Good. I go off on one thing sometimes a little bit too much and want to over-explain it. So I'm just trying to keep this simple today. I want to get a basics down in everybody's mind and make them think and realize this is not what we're being told it is. Okay, the whole point is I'm mentioning about all this with the electromagnetics and the biological effects that can be manipulated with this hidden, of what Tom Bearden calls an enfolded, hidden electromagnetic wave structure. And that also is exactly like the playbook of what keeps every different life structure in the world follows that playbook. And that is a hidden electromagnetic structure. So here that we've got scientists that have come up with, oh, now we see kind of how life has this playbook and how every cell depends on this playbook of electromagnetic structure. And it's hidden, but we found it. Of course, that gets used in one of two ways. It gets used the right way to help mankind and help the world around us, or it can be used the other way. And the Gulf of Mexico is obviously where it's being used the other way. And that's what everybody, I'm trying to make everybody aware of. You know, for everything that's good out there, there's something that with the same thing becomes bad. That's what's happening. The Corexit, now get your eyes off the Corexit, because obviously there is something that is being sprayed. It might be Corexit with some new chemicals in it. Who knows? But the oxygen is deliberately being destroyed to stop any growth of any kind of cellular structure within the Gulf of Mexico and along the shoreline, and in some witness cases, airplanes spraying it inside the shoreline, inland. Now, you're not spraying for oil inland. So I'm sorry, the whole thing about the Corexit, I think, is just a ploy. It's not to be the dispersant that they keep saying it's there to disperse the oil. The oil, first of all, is still there. And instead of dispersing the oil, we're getting this weird foam on the top of the water, which we're not allowed to test. EPA won't allow anybody to do it. I'm sure people have seen on the internet a guy went there to go, you know, build a sandcastle and, you know, was told by the law enforcement, no, you can't do that on the beach. You know, they're trying to keep it quiet as to what's really going on. But, hey, we have logic. The world has common sense. And, you know, we've got the internet where we can read what fantastic genius scientists have written about in the past and put it all together and say, this must be what's going on. And that's what I'm trying to get across today. Get your mind off of BP. How's that? All right. If BP, if the governments or BP or whatever, they're in collusion, I don't care. It doesn't matter because that's just a distraction. If BP did make a mistake and, you know, fractured the whole bottom of the ocean floor there and there's a lot of oil coming up, well, that's still the distraction. It's not what's going on that's much worse. That's the distraction. Now, this happened also in the Gulf War in 1990 in Iraq. The same thing where there was the cover of oil in the air everywhere, spewing up out of all the wellheads that were blown up, lakes of oil in the sand, and oil in the air, it was black. I'm sure everybody remembers those pictures on all the newscasts. It was a mess. But the biological damage done to soldiers who were out in that and civilians who were contracted to be out in all that to stop the wells from flowing and all that, all had very odd viral problems, and they said, okay, it came from the oil. Well, that's exactly what they're saying now, that everybody along the Gulf Coast is suffering effects from the oil and possibly, even though they don't want to admit it, possibly the oil dispersant chemicals. It could possibly be doing that. And have you noticed, Liz, how blatant these officials are, whether it's, you know, a Coast Guard official or an EPA official or whatever, where people have caught them on camera at news conferences and have interrupted them and said, look, there's an oil slick all along the inlet coming into our bay. And you just told us we can go fishing there now because there's no oil. And then they just turn around and go, well, you know, our last test didn't show any oil.
Yeah, they shut them right down.
Yeah, but even when they're confronted with the truth, yeah, they're confronted with truth, and yet they'll turn around and just stick to the story. So that, to me, tells me, and I don't know about you, to me that says they're following the plan, and they're not going to sway from it at all, which means that there is something much, much deeper about the whole thing, and that the oil really isn't the problem. Something more if they're going to make themselves look like absolute idiots and say there's no oil when the oil is right there.
Yeah. So well, I mean, not only look like – not. I'm sorry, go ahead.
No, that means cover-up. That's all that means. If you're going to stick to a story that you know is wrong and then have it proven in front of you that you're wrong and then you still stick to the story and you're an official spokesperson. Then you're covering up something else.
Yeah. I mean, I've seen them in town meetings and different meetings with the different fishermen and everything. And the fishermen will be standing there, you know, in these town meetings, and they'll be yelling at the officials that they're liars. And they still stick to their stories.